guys, it's Danny. Today we are working with, you'll never guess, the mini rose bush. Look at him. He looks so good. Well, not only is he still alive and still around, and not only did he put on quite a lot of green growth, he is riddled, literally riddled with tiny little buds, and I'm just so over the moon excited about it. The problem is, in all of this time, I didn't actually repot him, and he is potted in a tiny, tiny little pot that gets dry every other day, I swear, and I water him quite plentifully. He is thirsty. And well, to be fully honest, it's not just one plant in here. There were three. One of them didn't make it. It was a little bit sad from the moment that I got it, and now I can see that the entire stem has actually dried out. So I need to completely remove this plant, and I will definitely keep the other two, which now that I look at it, oh no, I have three plants. So there were four plants, four mini bushes actually in this tiny little pot, which when I say tiny, I mean tiny. Look at this, you guys. Oh my goodness, I watered him yesterday. It is bone dry already. So he absolutely needs a bigger pot. And I've kind of did a little bit of research. Apparently, it is a good idea to separate these plantlets, which I definitely should do, but I'm not gonna do. I'm not gonna do today. I will pot this entire bush in the same pot, a bigger pot, of course. It might be a mistake. I don't know what I'm doing. It's the first time that I'm trying to grow a mini rose bush. I don't know why it's working, but this is what I'm gonna try to do, because I really like to keep him in one space, because I really don't have a lot of space in this room, and growing him outside, no. I cannot take care of anything on the terrace, to be fully honest. He's not gonna make it. That's why I wanted to try him in the plant room. And it's doing okay. So this is not a tutorial. This is my journey and my experiment in the miniature rose department grown in a normal plant room with some grow lights where I kept this plant up until now. And I will keep you up to date. I will definitely tell you if I fail, you know me. But for now, this is what I wanna do. I might regret not dividing it. We'll see about that, I will let you know. So before we start with the repotting, don't forget to give this video a like if you end up enjoying it. And hey, why not subscribe? I post every single day. I post something about a plant every single day. Either it's a short, either a video. Anyway, with that said, let me get my gloves and my repotting tray. Oh, by the way, this little bush has little thorns. So I'm reconsidering now my choice of gloves. Maybe I should actually buy myself some stronger gloves. I don't have them. I'll try not to poke myself. But yeah, I should have definitely think this through. I'm not gonna go to the flower shop right now. We're just gonna do this as it is. And if I get scratched, I get scratched. What to do? Part of the job, isn't it? All right, so he's kind of already coming out of this pot. I'm just gonna try to grab one of the stems somewhere close to the base where I don't find any thorn, and ta-da, it wasn't hard, was it? So yeah, you can see there are quite a lot of roots in here, and thankfully this medium is not bone dry. I did notice that when it does get bone dry, all of the leaves tend to droop a little bit. And this bone dry situation happens every 3 days. So if I don't water it every other day, I absolutely need to water it every 3 days, which is a nightmare for me because I just am not used to this. So one thing that I always kind of like to do, again, not because I'm an expert, but it kind of makes sense to me, I like to get rid of the first layer of medium, because typically this is where potential pests reside, even fungus gnat larvae. And also, this is where dried leaves and debris, organic debris, tend to fall and gather. And I would rather not have them here and accumulate. So I am now going to detach this little guy. Oh, the roots were not good either. So it was super, super easy to detach him. And I am going to leave everything else be. Again, maybe not the best idea. Definitely, it would be ideal if each and every one of these guys would be potted together. I'm just not gonna do that right now and just see what happens. If I see bad stuff are starting to happen, I will definitely intervene and separate them, and I'll let you know about it. So, I just wanna remove the top part of the soil, and here I'm actually not going to bother the plant way too much. This soil actually looks pretty good. I'm just pretty sure it is depleted of nutrients at this point. So again, just the surface, the bottom layers, I'm just gonna leave them be. All right, so this is about it when it comes to cleaning up the root system. This is not an orchid, we don't need to clean up everything. So now let me show you the pot that I'm thinking about. Alright, so here's a pot I've been dying to try out. For those of you who are new on my channel, this pot has been sent to me by my long-term collaborators, repotme.com. This is part of PR. I didn't purchase this myself, it was sent to me. And even if this video is not paid by them or sponsored in any way, just so you know, I didn't purchase this pot, but it is the first time that I'm using it and it's quite pretty. It's one of those pots that has one of these dishes that attaches, but I did a little bit of a test and actually it can hold on to quite a little bit of water. Which for me is a good thing. I know that for most houseplant owners, can I talk? I know that for most houseplant owners, it's not a good idea to leave water sitting. For me, it is. In this climate, it is. I depend on the little reservoir here. Now, the soil that I will be using is a so-called rose soil. It is advertised as suitable for roses. It apparently is enriched with compost. I'm just showing you what the bag says. But I noticed it also contains some tiny little rocks, which I'm guessing they're used for drainage improvement. That's new, never used the soil before. So it looks good. I hope it's gonna be good. So the first thing that I'm gonna do is make a mess. So I guess it's a good idea to keep everything on the tray. So I'm just gonna start by placing some soil at the bottom of my pot. Oh, PS, I know some people ask me about this tray. It's an IKEA tray, just a random IKEA tray. I don't even know how it's called, but it's a very popular item at IKEA. I'm sure you're gonna find it if you have an IKEA near you. All right, let's see about the level. I'm not gonna pot it deeper than it was, so this would be too deep. Ooh, the little guy is spiky. Okay, I'm gonna hold it in a very weird and precarious position. Can you tell that I grow orchids, not houseplants? Certainly not rose bushes, but I wanna learn. I want to become the rosebush whisperer as well because I love roses and I wanna learn how to grow them in a home until I get my own garden. Let's see, this looks a little better. I think I can add just a little more and see about it. Okay, this looks a lot better. I think I'm gonna need a little bit more soil, but now I'm gonna start to add soil around the bush. And you can see this pot is quite a lot larger than the previous one. That is okay. For roses, they do actually need quite a lot of space in the pot. And yeah, this amount of soil will not be enough. Now, this soil says that it already contains nutrients that should last me for about 6 months or so. I don't know about that, to be fully honest. So what I will do is actually add a few nutrients of my own. I'm gonna use the Osmocote Pro High K fertilizer that I usually use with orchids. This is a slow release fertilizer and I find it to be very good. And when it comes to roses, more nutrients doesn't really hurt. They are pretty heavy feeders and pretty big drinkers, as I noticed. When you grow so many orchids, it's quite shocking to get a plant that can drink so much. Orchids really don't drink a lot of water in comparison. Ow, it's biting me. What I will try to do is leave a little bit of space in between the soil level and the level of the pot, because when I water, I don't want that water to spill over the pot, which can happen. And really, I don't know how the soil will behave when it's gonna be a little bit dry. Some soils really, really repel water, especially those peat-based soils. Honestly, this doesn't look like that type of soil, but you never know. So I'm gonna leave a little bit of a lip just for water to accumulate and not spill over when I water. And you know what? I think we are about done. How about that? Now, let me tell you a few words about how I treated this plant, because I didn't do much. I did, however, cut away the blooms it came with. Most of them and most of the buds yellowed off, they didn't last, they didn't rebloom, so I cut them off. I didn't actually follow the, let's say, classical rose pruning rule that says that you need to go down to a leaf that has three leaflets. Oh gosh, don't listen to what I'm saying right now. I'm not a rose expert. So bottom line, you need to cut at a certain level. You need to go down at a certain level and find an outward eye where you can cut. Well, I didn't do that with this rose bush because I do remember either it was a video or an article I read. With these guys, it's not important to go so low, because what happens is on normal roses, if you don't go low enough to a node that can produce a shoot which can bloom, they will produce a very thin shoot which will not be able to bloom. It is apparently not the case with this rose bush. I don't know about it, to be fully honest, and I'm just noticing a leaf that has a little bit of damage. I don't know if this is spider mite or anything. It was here when I purchased it, so I'm just gonna remove this leaf. And also, many of you told me that roses are spider mite magnets. I do know about that. So I did spray it a little bit with my leaf shine solution. I did a little bit of this because especially on new growth is where spider mites like to stay. I didn't see anything so far, but I am keeping an eye on it. And yeah, whatever suspicious leaf that I see, I just remove. I'm not even going to keep it. It's just gonna be removed. There we go. So yeah, I am definitely keeping an eye on it and just spraying it with a leaf shine a little bit. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I will share with you a link down below. My preferred method to control pests is oil, mineral oil. In my region, I don't have a lot of options. I don't really have much to choose from. So because I can find leaf shine with paraffin oil, you know, it's what I want. I just want the oil to smother the insects. I've never had good luck with vegetable oil, be it neem, be it anything else. It's just a headache that doesn't even work. When you have a lot of plants and you don't have enough time to spray every day or every 2 days, you just want something that works on the spot, and paraffin oil works on the spot. That was just a little disclaimer. I'm not saying you should spray all of your plants with leaf shine, it's just what I do. Do please check the description for that video that explains a lot more. Don't start to spray your rose bushes with that just because I said so. But yeah, I do explain myself in that video. All right, so I'm gonna water this little orchid, oh my gosh, this little bush. You know what? I'm not gonna end this video here. I'm gonna end it when the buds bloom. I really hope they weren't stressed by the repot. I'll let you know. So I'll come back with more footage when it's gonna be in bloom, because it's a beautiful rose. And here we are a few weeks later, my rose is kind of in bloom. Yeah, a few of the buds didn't actually make the repot. I think definitely roses are more sensitive to these things than orchids are, but I do have a few buds still that are just opening up. One of them is a little slanted. Anyway, I don't mind. It is really, really beautiful. And it's going pretty great. I did not keep it in direct sunshine. I actually kept it in this shelf with the grow lights for most of the time. There was some natural light, but definitely not for a lot of hours. And it actually did great. So I'm pretty happy with it. We'll see how it does in the long run. I cannot wait to trim it a little more because the base of the stems is pretty bare. But I guess that will be fixed in the future. So yeah, that's about it for today, you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you've enjoyed this video. I will keep you up to date with this little rose. Wish me luck. I hope he's gonna be around a year from now. Actually, my mom has a mini rose bush for about a year now, and yeah, it's doing great. It just needs a trim because it's a little leggy. So we'll see how this one does, but thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this, and I also hope you have a great day. Subscribe to my channel for more orchid videos, tutorials, experiments, updates, and other fun orchid subjects. If you wish to support the channel, do consider becoming a member or visit the merch store linked down below in the description. You can also follow me on Instagram and Facebook. It's always nice to stay in touch there as well. And with that said, I'll see you next time. Bye!